that stuff. That's why we're getting routed right now. So looking over here at the economic calendar, what's up, Reese? Morning, buddy.
Morning, good morning.
How are you?
I'm doing great, doing good.
Beautiful.
How's everybody this morning?
I'm great, man. It seems like
That's
everyone
good.
else is too. So looking over here, we had CPI yesterday, came out a little bit higher than a previous, but it's way below what the previous was over here. So with that being said, I think maybe this data is showing that the rate increases are helping just a little bit. I still think inflation's like off the charts. It's ridiculous, and it should not be like that, but it is, right? So that's just from all the printing of money. Can't be printing so much money and handing it out to people. It's just not gonna work, right? Like you have to do it during the pandemic for a few months, but not the amount that they did, right? Because what they're doing now, it's like it seems like free money. It seems like money that we could just, print out and throw away and give to other people and stuff like that. But you're just mortgaging our future. You're hurting our future because now that dollar is going to be worth less. So, that whole policy is not too smart. But moving into this morning, prelim GDP came out worse than expected. But not only that, you had GDP coming out month to month below negative a tenth percent, and you have all these other data points negative, right? So you saw a further drop on GJ. We broke 160 yesterday, and now we're just tanking. So I think we're around like 157 now. What are we? Yeah, 157 flat, I would say we're sitting right at right now. So that's can we continue to drop is the real question, right? So today our main focus gonna be PPI, right? Core PPI, unemployment gain claims as we go over every Thursday. So we'll see how these numbers come out. Previous was 1.4. Previous over here for core was 1.0, and now they're expecting maybe that to split in half, right? So we'll see what we end up getting over here. But looking over here at the charts now, looking at GJ right now, again, we have that recovery since COVID, right? Price just been working its way up. Higher highs, higher lows. We had this consolidation period between 149 and 158, right? We've just been consolidating in there, and now we're starting to come right back below. Now, looking at the candle anatomy here to the left of where price is at right now, you have this whole resistance right here that price is now sitting in, right? You have all these wicks and these candle bodies at 157 and 158. That's always been a high interest area where prices just drops from there, right? Price just drops every single time we tap into this area. So now, can we hold support here and kind of just rally from this area, just like it did from coming up from the bottom part of it to continue back down? Can we do the same thing up here where we hold support and continue up? Looking at the daily now. Now we're starting to get into all this consolidation over here to the left. So what I want to do is just kind of like draw 157,300 is an area that we used to mark off when we were in these areas. We used to mark this off as the candle body highs, 157,300 right here. But we can always adjust this as we go down the time frames to see where our most recent support and resistance is. But so far over here on the daily, you have this next support as our next area, at least on the daily. And that's right below 156. Looking at the 4 hour now, you're seeing that this candle is starting to retest that area. Not to mention the previous 4 hour candle closed with no bottom wick over here. So you're going to get some sort of a retracement in this area to continue down possibly. You had a very strong bearish move over here, coming down, mirroring these moves. We're now sitting right here, which I'm going to mark off previous resistance and support right here at 156,500, right? That's resistance right there. Now we can adjust this right here is you get a clean move right here to the left that you can take something right here. Looking at the 1 hour now, I've been looking at the setup right now and waiting for price to hold a resistance, and we're starting to do so, I think, on the 15 minute. So we're starting to reject this area a little bit. This 1 hour candle is getting a little bit weaker, right? So can we hold a resistance to continue down? 30 minute is starting to form a perfect setup right here. We got about 7 minutes left. No, about 6 minutes left. Yeah, about 7 minutes left for this 30 minute candle to close. Also the 1 hour candle, let's see if it closes like a weaker candle, but 7 o'clock volume should be pushing us down to continue down over here, possibly. 15 minute is now holding a resistance past the low of the previous candle over here. So can we be continuing down? One thing I always tell you guys to check is this range. Got plenty of pips in there. You got about 80 pips that you could grab in here. So can we grab at least 20 to 30? Absolutely. So let's see how this setup forms. Let's see how this candle closes over here. Got about 6 more minutes left. So we'll see what ends up happening here on GJ. I'm just going to edit this, put this here. Guys, when you get a chance, send your charts in here so we could go over them and see what you guys are looking at. Again, this is not for me. This is for you, right? That's how you guys get better. So send your charts in so we see, you know, what you're looking at, and then we'll go from there. Gold right now is just kind of ranging a little bit. Actually, we're starting to break below previous consolidation. All right, so we'll break down gold real quick, and we'll be monitoring GJ for now before the hour close. All right, so gold, again, we just keep breaking down into this area, right? Coming right back down into 1830, tapping into 1830, previous resistance of this consolidation over here between 1750 and 1830. So now we're coming back down into this key area. This right here is what I would call a key area, where you have a previous resistance meeting up with a trend, with a very valid trend as well. Price is pushing up from this level multiple times, right? So now we're starting to tap into that area again. Can we hold support and return back up? So that's an interesting question, because we have interest rates that have been rising. So I'm just going to get rid of that for now. Now looking over here, since tapping 2000, pricing in all the rate increases of all the central banks, especially the Fed, we've just been making lower lows and lower highs over here, pushing all the way back down into 1830, right? Now looks like we're holding some kind of a resistance at this previous support here, which we can mark off right now. All right, so we got that previous support, now a resistance. Looks like price is starting to push down to retest the lows over here and finally actually tap into 1830. Now the 4 hour is starting to look good. We ended up getting a strong 4 hour candle right here. And then what we had was a little support that we were holding right here. This candle finally closed below it with a wick to fill. This candle created a top wick, retested this range, flipped bearish past the low of the previous, and closed bearish. This candle is creating a higher or lower high right here, right? And flipping bearish over here to continue down. So can we anticipate price to retest these lows over here? Is that a trade we want to take? Now you have this move over here to the left, and again, this support. Just going to mark this off right here so you guys know. Now, all these wicks, very interesting. Get this candle close, like right at this level right here. This candle rejected. This candle rejected again. This candle kind of closed below, right? Kind of closed below that level. This candle retested up here, closed bullish, but below this level. This candle created a top wick, grab liquidity, flip bearish, and now it's below this level now again, right? So now where are we going from here? It's the 1 hour. Let's look at the 30 minute. So the 30 minute now is kind of just like consolidating right in here, right? It's a little tricky to see. But right now we want price to kind of close below. This level right here, and you guys are going to have plenty of room to take a trade like right into this like general area, which is about 100 pips, right? So I would wait for that close below this area. Let's see if it does on the 1 hour, right? Let's see if this candle closes below this bullish candle, or do we hold support on the 1 hour right here? But if we hold support there on the 1 hour, but it closes bearish, the next candle I could see creating a small top wick, passing the low of these wicks. If you're more of an advanced trader and you know gold, I could see price, you know, continuing down with that 7 a.m. volume, 7:30 volume, somewhere around there. That makes sense?
Yes, sir.
So I think this is your move right into here. That's what I'd be looking for. I wouldn't be taking any kind of buys until we start to break like 1865, 1860. I mean, maybe if you want to take something after 1857, but it starts to get a little choppy. And plus, like, why would you want to be buying gold right now? They would only be short-lived buys, kind of like this right here, maybe like this move right here if you wanted to take it. But everything is like waiting for that resistance to form. So you can take the sell back down to retest the lows. Just hop on the train. You don't have to like be fighting the market the whole time. Always trying to like call tops, call bottoms. Just not like that. All right, so the 1 hour candle closed bearish, but above that level. But GJ over here right now is holding that resistance with a nice strong candle. So once this candle creates a top wick, starts passing the low of that candle, I can put my stop loss up here and we could take this. So it'd be something like right here. Stop loss would be right here. TP would be right down here, be about a 1 to 2, 55 pips that we're looking for. We got Gary in here. We got Carlos. What's up, boys? Reese, we already talked.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, my friend. How are you?
Doing great. I can't complain. How you doing?
Good shit, man. I saw that you were 3-1 this week.
Yeah, bro.
Let's go, baby. Good shit. Just taking good, disciplined entries. Or I keep hiccuping.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, logical trades.
Good. So this setup is what I'm talking about. We ended up closing above this support, but a bearish candle, which passed the low of the previous candle. So if we could create a top wick over here in the first couple minutes of the candle and then start passing the low of this wick, I can see it's continuing down. And that'll be a nice move on gold. We have two different trades that we could possibly be taking right now. This is Thursday. We normally get some solid volume. You have the fundamentals behind GJ for you to take any kind of sell. Those fundamentals should help you. Again, I'm not in this right now, but I'm, you know, this is what I'm looking to take. I am looking at gold pretty well.
I was going to take the GJ 30 minute close, but I remembered. Wait for the top wick.
There you go. Always. All right.
I had a question. Does anybody in here use the on-screen magic keys?
Gary does.
So do I.
Jimmy does as well, yeah. So Jimmy does too. Awesome.
What do you guys think of it?
I love it. I actually have both. I stopped using my physical one because it has a tendency to disconnect from the dongle. and caused you some issues. It's frozen up a few times, but the on-screen one, the only issue I've ever had was having it ask me to reactivate the license. But since I upgraded to 185, I haven't had an issue with it since.
Nice. Just uploading my workout while we're waiting here. I'm just uploading my workout from yesterday. Yeah, like I said, I think I turned the corner around like 2 or 3 o'clock yesterday, and after that, I was pretty solid. Bike hit everything. This. All right. Jamie, good shit, buddy. I just want to, okay, beautiful. Is this NTD? Yep, NTD USD. Perfect. Yeah, right here.
Yep.
So I just want to give me 1 second. I just want to stay on the chart real quick because we're starting to get our moves here. Candle's starting to flip over here on DJ. Let's look at the other time frames real quick. 1 hour candle did close a strong bullish candle. So you got to be aware right now. But 30 minute did close bearish. Right, this candle's creating a top wick, starting to flip bearish over here. Once it passes the low, I'm going to be taking this. Gold starting to pass or starting to, you know, flip bearish. But yeah, Jamie, very simple breakdown. I love it. Easy.
Thank you, sir.
Of course, man. For it to break the low. Anybody else looking to take the same thing?
Yeah, my finger's on the buzzer.
Awesome. All right, I am in. I'm in GJ. I have a small position on gold. Stop loss, like right in the middle of that range right here, anticipating this drop. I could just monitor both at the same time. Does this make sense, guys?
Yeah, I got a small position on GJ as well.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I haven't just entered just yet, but I'm looking for sells on GU, so.
GU? Sells on GU?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Everyone understand that setup on gold?
It's the same setup I set. I was describing in London.
Oh, were you?
Yep.
I see. I was on the Zoom this morning with Luke, so I didn't get a chance to look at the London channel this morning yet.
I was breaking it down for Praveen.
You were breaking it down for Praveen?
Yeah.
Where is this today? Oh, there we go. Was this today?
Yep.
Yeah, it was. Wow. You guys had it. Wow. Look at you guys. Good shit, boys. I'm going to have to read through this later.
But I was teaching.
Yeah, can you give me like a gist of...
teaching him about the liquidity wick because he... obviously, it was at a support level.
Yeah,
and he asked if we could buy, so I sort of broke it down and said, "No, not yet. You obviously need confirmation of that." And then the liquidity candle sort of appeared, took out the previous high. Then we started rejecting back down and all that sort of thing. And then you had the London open volume as well. So,
well done, my man. Appreciate that.
And it actually melted down 100 pips.
Melted down 100 pips.
Yeah. But I didn't take it because I'd already taken one in the morning earlier on.
Yeah, no, that's good shit. So. Oh, sorry guys, it's looking at my other screen.
I see the Asian session was a bit lively.
Yeah, it was nice. We got to keep that up.
A little chatting in there.
Yeah. I mean, we had some good moves.
Yesterday. After that daily close, wasn't it?
Which daily close? Oh, yesterday's. After the flip.
Yeah, it was massive, wasn't it?
Yeah, massive flip. That's why I took that trade yesterday, guys. It was based on the daily.
Yeah. I was tempted to set a sell stop below the daily low, but means it would have hit overnight whilst I was asleep.
Yes, sir. You know, part of me feels like we're selling the low on GJ over here, which I don't like. But it's our setup. We're committing to it. But on the higher time frames, it definitely looks like we're selling the low. We also got to keep in mind we got PPI coming out at 8:30. There's not much volume right now.
Yeah, GU's reaction to the news yesterday was pretty crazy, but I didn't take any trades.
GU?
Yeah, like I was on my way to work and I just had the charts open while I was driving and at the same time, news for, I think it was US dollars, all of a sudden price just it shorted like crazy. Pretty big move, so.
Yeah, well, we had, what, you talking about from CPI or from GDP?
One sec here.
It was during London, GDP, or?
It would have been 8:30 your guys, your time.
Okay.
So 7:30, yeah, 7:30 my time.
Okay.
So that was CPI.
Yeah, send the chart. I want to see what it looked like on there.
How you feeling?
How am I feel? Oh, from yesterday?
Yeah.
Oh, much better. Much better. I felt better around like two or three. in the afternoon. Yeah, it was brutal. I feel like shit.
Weren't your wife stodgy cooking, was it?
Yeah, I blamed her.
You put a picture up, didn't you?
Yep. Forget extreme ownership. It was all her fault. Oh, why is this over here? There we go. Dodgy cooking. Yeah, I think top 10 things that I love is like the sayings that you guys have in England.
Join in. Repeat some back.
Yeah, like England, Ireland, like you guys have like some of the best just like words or definitions of things. I don't know. It's hard to describe what it is, but I love it. Yeah, 2 minutes left for the 15 minutes to close. So this 15 minute closes on gold. I don't like how we're stalling here on GJ. And the way that the 5 minute looks, let me see the 1 minute. I'm just gonna eye up the 1 minute for a second here. Because the 15 minute was supposed to flip and continue down. And so was the 30 minute. Not like stall around here after holding this support down here. So the 15 minute did close bullish over here. So I'm just going to cut a little risk off with the candle closing in the opposite direction here. Yeah, I'm having a funny feeling about GJ. Anybody else?
I'm still in this. I don't know. I'm just going to wait for the 30 minute, I think.
I just don't like how we're holding that support right there. It's like a higher low.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm going to jump out of this. Yeah. Yeah, I took like 80% off just because I don't like that wasn't my plan. That's the reason why I'm taking this off. Like it could very well continue to drop, but my plan for this and this setup works out when this candle closes the way it does. And then this candle creates a top wick, starts passing the low of that candle. And then we just continue down. Like that was the plan for the trade, but we weren't getting that. We're not getting that right now. We got a bullish close in the 15 minute. This candle's creating a bottom wick, starting to flip bullish. So, yeah, I don't like how that was forming.
Yeah, I'm completely out.
Good. Take this off. And also, like, if you look at the 1 minute too, 1 minute is kind of like, you could see it create like this double bottom and like, you know, we created a higher low over here and we're just continuing up, right? So now could we be creating a higher low right here to continue right back up? Like I said, we could very well continue down, but I don't know. With the way the 1 hour looks right here, I think it's too strong to continue down here. We sent this over. Let me take a look at Jamie's first. So yeah, Jamie, you're just looking for this the break of this area to either side. Do you have a clean move to the left on the bottom side of the support?
Oh, so if you go up to like the weekly, the only thing you're gonna see is you go to the weekly on that. Actually, I can either send it or you can open up a chart. Hang on a second. Probably easier for me to just send it. It looks kind of garbage-like. I mean, there's one little clean candle sitting over there that we could possibly take to go down. And that whole drop is about 300 pips. So there's some moves in there it can take. Okay. But it's not, you know, the ultimate. Hang on a second, I got it right here. Send it to you right now.
Appreciate it.
Little open that.
Okay, yeah. Hey, this is what we were breaking down the other day. That clean move to the left over here. It could possibly mirror down to this support. Got how many pips right there?
309.5, so call it 310.
Okay. Okay. And then yeah, I mean, you could see the bearish pressure right here, and then you get another lower high over here, but we are holding this support. So again, just wait for that close below, take this thing down.
Okay.
That's all you're waiting for. This is too small of a range for you to trade in.
Yeah, that's 19 pips when I measured that. I'm like, nope, that's green with that.
Yeah, there you go. Smart, man. CPI. So Reese, what is this? Oh, this is pound dollar.
It's pretty much the chart for when the news happened yesterday. So that was pretty much the drop.
For the 30 minute. Okay. And then we've got a complete correction, rejected 123.90, and then continue down. Okay.
But then that move that happened there for CPI, like I was watching it happen on the 5 minute.
Mm-hmm.
The 5 and the 15, and I could have entered at the time, but like I had a lot going on, so it was like whatever.
Okay.
Like on to the next one again, like you said, right? So yeah. Can't really don't want to stress or change my thoughts because I didn't take a trade or I missed it. So
there you go. Good shit, man. Discipline. All right, so let's go back to the charts over here. PJ's starting to flip back again. Are you still in this, Sammy?
Yeah, I'm still in it.
Okay, nice.
I was thinking I was going to manage on a 30 rather than a 15.
Mm-hmm.
Because 15 does tend to give you misinformation sometimes.
Yeah.
So
it's still like how weak this candle has been. It's been like a doji. Just about. Especially with the 1 hour candles, the way they are. But we'll see.
Now I want this to close below that support. If it closes below that support, we'll be okay.
Yeah. We have to keep heading down here on gold. Nah. Gold's playing on them. We shall see how the 30-minute closes. If it closes below the support, if not, then I'll be cutting off risk. See how GJ like formed our resistance, but at the same time, it's not playing out the way we planned on it. Like for this setup to happen, like we need that top wick to form. Price to pass the low of that candle and we continue down at least 10 pips where we secure stops at break even. With this, like you pass the low, flip bullish, 15-minute closes bullish. I'm curious how this 15-minute closes.
I'd say GU and GJ are pretty similar, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Movement-wise.
Yeah, they move pretty similarly.
Yeah, because as you're talking about GJ, I'm like looking at GU right now, and it's like everything you're saying is pretty much the same thing.
Yeah, I've noticed that. They both move very similarly. Reese, you've been using this playlist?
Yeah, I've been using it during my journaling. I use it at work. Like, what playlist is this? This is pretty cool.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Did someone ask that?
Pardon?
Did someone just ask what playlist it was? Or was that you?
That was me. Like, oh no, that was my coworkers.
Oh, they were saying that. Yeah, okay. That makes sense.
Because I put it on at work, and then they were like hearing the movie scores and stuff. They're like, what playlist is this?
Yeah, it's relaxing.
And like usually at work, like there's a lot going on. It's like pretty loud. As soon as I put that playlist on, everybody went quiet. After like 10 minutes.
It's like,
I was like, it was crazy, man. I was like, actually work.
It's like a kindergarten class ready for nap time.
Yeah, because my one coworker was like, hey, Andrew, you notice that everybody's quiet right now? I'm like, yeah.
That's amazing. You just looking good. I'm going to wait for this 30 minutes to close on GJ and I may re-enter. Just because it looks so good. Yeah. About 2 minutes left.
I'm like 5 pips away from my 1-to-1.
Beautiful. What was your entry? Sammy?
Sorry, I'm muting myself. 156.040. We broke the low and then we went a bit open then I entered.
157.040?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, nice. Awesome. 30-minute closed. Let's see price drop on both of these.
Hey, you called it out.
What's up?
You called it out, the trade.
Yeah, man. We all did. I don't have, like how the 30 minutes passed in the low right away. Well, it could be okay.
I just closed the entire thing.
Nice.
Well, yeah, that was my first trade of the week. So.
Yeah, wow, you haven't taken many things this week yet.
Huh? It's been very busy. Yeah. Like the only time I've had it is just the time with you guys.
True.
Like, you know that GJ's been trash, right?
Oh, yeah.
So that's why I couldn't really... Actually, the moves happened late London and late New York, didn't they, this week?
Yeah, it's definitely late New York.
Yeah, so, hey, you know, my house is crazy at the minute.
You get the holidays going.
But yeah, that's just like, it shows that the level of patience you need, even when you are busy, because when you are busy, you can't concentrate to the level you want to.
Oh, man.
So even if you do take one trade or two trades, as long as it's the right trade and it's the right setup and you waited for it and you've seen it and you've given all your time to the market, that given time, you shouldn't be worried at all, in my opinion.
100%. I just closed gold out. I'm out of this.
Nice.
As soon as this candle started flipping over here, it's just too many wicks, right? Too many, kind of like this setup over here, just too many wicks. A lot of times I see this setup, I'm sure a couple of you guys have seen this too. We get a close like this, right? Passing the low over here. And then once this candle creates a top wick and passes the low, we just drop. We get a nice like 40, 50 pips out of that. And it's just off to the races. Like that's what we like. But it's stalling too much here. And we have news coming out in an hour. So I'm just, maybe we just continue to consolidate here until so. but TJ over here. See, what I like on TJ is the fact that we're creating this, we created a lower high and a lower low on the 1 hour, right? And past the low. So it's a valid resistance on the higher time frames. It looks like we could continue this move down. We're just hopping on the train. Let's see what we do. I just don't, with this 1 30-minute candle, I don't want to see us like struggle because we don't have the top wick. I'm not going to secure now, but if we start coming back to my entry, then I'll be trying to cut off some losses. But sometimes, like, you know, you'll get a candle like this where you have no top wick and we just drop. I'm kind of thinking this may be it. At least, like, not drop, but, like, just drop back down to the support, tap into it.
Can't see it dropping much more.
You don't?
No, not today. It's already dropped quite heavily and it had a big move yesterday as well.
Really did. That's what I was saying. Like, I feel like we're kind of selling the bottoms, but
yeah,
I like this setup.
I can't see it breaking 156,500.
Yeah.
Are you looking to take anything, Steph?
What's up?
Are you looking to take anything else, or are you?
I mean, I did. I took this in gold. So, like, I'll be active. I'll be obviously on here with you guys and seeing what we could take. But for me, like, I'm starting to get to that criteria where, you know, those trades start getting more emotional than they are logical when you're taking more than like two or three. It's like, you got to relax a little bit.
Yeah, it's sort of control your emotions. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Probably one of the hardest things to do. And that's what I like about you. You're very honest, you know, even if you're having problems, you say it the way it is, you know.
Yeah, man. I mean, that's the only way we get better. It's just like, you know, straight transparency, getting better. Like, we're all human. You know, whether you've been trading for a long time or you're a really successful trader or just starting out, like, everyone's going to always have the same, like, everyone's going to be human and everyone's going to have the same mistakes. It's just like, you know, maybe I have, or you have, or some people that are more experienced have, they make less mistakes and they make better decisions. but you're always going to have mistakes that you make in the market that just say, oh, damn, I could have done this a little bit better. Mm. I could have been better on this one.
Do you still talk to like your mentors?
I do Brandon. Raquel, I don't really talk to as much anymore.
Okay. At least you have someone to talk to, right?
Yeah. Oh, about trading?
Yeah.
No, Brandon became more of a friend, and I stopped trading the way he does, like a long time ago. So he's just more of my boy. He actually came to my wedding. But okay. But yeah, I really only talk to you guys, and I do my own self analysis, and I stay disciplined on my own and all that stuff. So I mean, everyone should have a mentor. I wish I had somebody like above me that like I could consult with about like maybe how I can help you guys and stuff like that, or you know, with my own trading. But like at this point, I'm good.
How come you don't talk to Raquel anymore? Is it you had a tiff or is it?
No. What's it called? When I lost my last Instagram, I kind of lost touch with a lot of those guys. Monty, Kerwin, I talked to on Instagram a little bit, but like Raquel, I used to talk to a lot on either Slack or Instagram. I don't know. We kind of went our own ways.
Yeah.
Just like kind of like catching up, stuff like that now.
Fizzled out, right?
What's up?
Say like something kind of fizzled out.
Yeah, a little bit. You know,
there's no like issues with the two of you.
No, it's just
went your own way, right? Both of you took separate paths and
exactly. Your way. Exactly, man.
One thing I need like help with is that I never leave runners. I always take profit at 1-to-1, the full thing.
Have you been like backtesting it?
No.
Yeah, if you start backtesting a lot more with that, you're gonna see that you're a lot more in touch with like holding your trades a little bit longer, letting them go.
Yeah, I was saying we need to book a backtesting session.
Yeah, let's do it. What do I have?
I've never had one with you.
I know, we got to do it. Let's see what we got. Let's see. So Sunday, okay. So Sunday, this is actually Paul's idea, but you know, it's something we used to do a lot more back when Sharma and I used to do we used to do, remember we used to do the breakdowns on Sundays on Instagram?
No.
Anybody remember that?
I don't.
You don't? Okay. So Sharma and I used to do 12 o'clock noon Eastern Standard Time. Every Sunday we would do a full breakdown on Instagram live and just break down the charts and the fundamentals on that. Now we do it on YouTube, which is a little bit more practical. But with that, like I've been mentioning to her that I want to pick that back up again. Instead of doing breakdowns on Monday where we're both like really busy, now we have a set time on Sundays that at noon that we can like do this full breakdown. But what I used to do on those Sundays, because I had more time, is I would do that full breakdown with them, and then you guys, like, we would hop on a Zoom as soon as I'm done with that, and we would do a backtesting session every other week. So what I'm going to do is we're going to do that this weekend on Sunday around noon. I want to see if she's going to be available to do a breakdown this Sunday. And if she is, we'll do that first, and then we'll do the backtesting session, and then, like, go over certain things for the week, as far as, like, what we're looking for, stuff like that. I want to start this back up on Sundays again. It's just a lot easier for me too with the amount of stuff I have going on during the week. Like, sometimes I can't even get to the breakdown with Sharma, or she can't get to it because it's too hard on a Monday, and maybe I'm available, she's not. It's just too difficult. But Sundays, we could both make that time available for us.
Is that going to be as a group or just you guys doing it?
It'll, depending on how we do it, if we do it on Instagram, it'll be Instagram Live. But if it's a backtesting session, it's us as a group.
Okay. I like it as a group anyway.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Paul used to do it in his group.
Yeah, we can definitely do a one-on-one backtesting session, but the one as a group is great as well.
Yeah. What days do you have then, bro?
What days what?
What days do you have?
Free. Do I have what?
For a backtesting session.
Oh, open?
Yeah.
Yeah, I would say next week we could do Monday.
Yeah, that's good.
Want to do Monday after the session?
Yeah, after session. That's normally best for me, straight after the session.
Okay. Monday. We'll say like 9:30.
Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful. I'll see you then.
Yep.
Let's go back to DJ. Full disclosure, guys, I did re-enter on this one. After, nice. What's up?
Nice.
Yeah, this camera created the top wick, and I was monitoring it on the lower time frames. As soon as we finally broke this bearish candle right here, I took this and then closed the full thing around 35 pips.
Did you just say you ain't bringing it to GJ?
No. I do have a small position on GJ from up here, right? But which I should actually have the thing here for you. But I closed a lot of it when this wick started coming up, and the 15-minute started holding that support, looking like we're going to continue up and hold support from here. But on gold, what I did was, as soon as we created that top wick and passed low this 15-minute candle with that 7:30 a.m. volume, I was looking for that push, and that's what we ended up getting. That's what I wanted before, but it was just messing around way too much, right? This 30-minute close above that level, which in any case, my rules, I'm going to cut 50, right? So I was just managing risk a little bit, but I got my re-entry here, closed the full thing at 35 pips, a little bit more than 1-to-1, and then now I'm out. Now, I would have left a runner and everything there, but one, we have news, and two, that was like a re-entry. So I'm just looking to like grab my profits from any of the loss that I took managing the risk, and then make a little, you know, some more money or cut some more pips. That's gold. TJ here.
How's your crypto doing?
Me?
Yeah.
I barely trade crypto. I have some Bitcoin and Ethereum holdings. But other than that,
must be down by now, don't you?
Oh yeah, I mean, if you look at Bitcoin, look at Bitcoin.
Mad. See, this is why I don't buy crypto, because I couldn't hold it down during that down.
Yeah,
it would break me.
Well, I mean, if your main thing is like this is going to change finance forever, and it's going to be a good holding over a long period of time, then you hold on to Bitcoin and you don't even like really look at the chart. You're just buying into Bitcoin and hoping that at some point we reach 68,000 again, or we continue up to 100,000, continue up to 120,000, right? When you have all these regular currencies besides the US dollar right now, because you have an increase in interest rates, but at the same time, the dollar, wow, that's crazy how strong it is right now. Looking at like fiat currencies, like the dollar over here, we've just been making lower highs, right? And lower lows. Right now, we are holding a support over here with everything going on in the past couple of years. but at the same time, you know, fiat currencies as a whole are losing value because you're printing more. Right now, they're making it more valuable by increasing rates. But some say that the future of finance is Bitcoin, or it is crypto. So just like trying to hedge that and understand that, that's what's going to help you like hold on to that.
Can you use crypto in the shops in America?
Do we have what?
Can you use like crypto in the shops?
Certain ones.
Yeah. So we don't have any of that here. As far as I know. No, we're still just normal British pound. So that's why it doesn't really faze me or anything about it at all.
You know what I keep hearing about like London and the UK and everything? You guys never have any garbage in the streets. Why is that?
Never have what, sorry?
No garbage in the streets.
Garbage. I'm gonna let Gary answer that.
Because we have bins.
You have bins?
Yeah, yeah. Big like industrial ones.
Yeah, a client that was taken back from the airport was telling me they were just coming back from London, and just like they were astonished by how much garbage, like there's just nothing. No litter.
Yes, because you
city.
That's because like all your shops and restaurants just bag it up and put it out, and then you just get piles of black bags, don't you?
In New York, yeah.
Yeah, and then like a lorry comes and picks it up. But yeah, we have the same in a way, but it's in a big industrial bin, so like it's tidier, isn't it?
True. GJ looks good. Wish I didn't micromanage this. Been doing that a lot lately, since the wedding. Just been like micromanaging some trades. I'm catching some great trades, but some of them I'm just like, it's almost like you're afraid to lose. Here we go, GJ. I'm going to secure a little piece right here.
How's your challenge going? Have you passed it yet?
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm aiming for the 400,000 soon. Yeah. Only get a payout first, but I'm going to grab the 400,000 account, I think.
Who did you do it with?
What's up?
Who did you do it with?
Funded Trader. But the 400,000 is what I've been backtesting a lot. Like if you go, where's my, this is a $100,000 account, but I backtested. Can you guys see this right here?
Yeah.
From the SoftFX?
Yeah.
So like this is an account I've been growing on gold since the beginning of 2021. So I've gone through 3 months already. Actually, no, 2 months. We're in the beginning of beginning of March here. So I've grown this around 65% within the basically 2 months. What I'm doing was I was backtesting gold last week. I was able to update the data on Soft4fx, and I used that to trade gold of last week and backtest gold of last week. But every time I do that every week, I do that with a $400,000 account just to get used to, you know, risking like anywhere from 15 to 20 to 30 lot or 50 lots. I'm getting used to seeing that type of money.
That's good, though. What's up? It's a good way to do things.
Yeah, Soft4fx is beautiful in that regard. I mean, getting better as a trader, upping your skill, getting used to the money, getting used to having to manage an account. When I say getting used to the money, getting used to, like, if one of your problems, which was mine in the beginning, was, like, risking more, right, and making more money in the market, risking more money in the market, higher lot sizes, stuff like that. That's where Soft4fx comes in, because it's like you want to get used to trading a $400,000 account. You'll get real used to it real quick the more you backtest.
Yeah.
It's not like TradingView where it's just like it needs some work, TradingView on the backtesting software or the Rewind tool. This is nice, Reese. You took this?
Yeah, I'm in there right now. Beautiful. I'm trying to get to, I'm thinking about closing right now. Quick 10 pips, right? Get out of there. So,
You have more than 1-to-1. You grab 10 pips?
Not yet.
So again, one of those checklist things that we have on your trading plan is always be aware of the time, right? So what time is it right now?
7:55.
Yeah. So you're going to have the hour closed pretty soon, about 5 minutes. This is where I normally like to take a piece off. But yeah, I like this, how we have that resistance right here, forming this lower high. You get this candle close right here, right? Nice, strong, bearish candle close. And you took it after top wick was formed on this candle and started breaking the low of this support. You took it before it broke the low of that wick?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, awesome. Now, before the hour closed, I just want to use the bathroom really quickly, and then I'll be right back, all right?
How's everyone's trading going this week?
All right, did you see?
So far, so good.
That's
been taking it lightly, though, because I pretty much just came back from Asia, so.
Okay. How about you, Jamie? How's NZD USD trading you?
It's been moving nicely. I just haven't had a lot of confidence in what I'm seeing to execute the trades. So I'm just journaling what I'm seeing. That way, you know, the more I see it, I'll be ready to take it.
Yeah, just gain that confidence, you know what I mean?
Yep.
Are you here, Quentin?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, didn't trade this week. I took DJ just now, but ended up with like break even, closing a small portion in loss, and the rest of it in profits to like just even it out.
Yeah,
But yeah, I have to backtest more, and especially I think live backtest, and to start taking small positions during the sessions.
Have you taken anything else this week or just?
Monday didn't trade at all. I was coming back from my trip, my weekend in Paris. Like I took the train at 6:30 a.m. and all that, and it took me some time this week to get back on tracks. Yesterday I had work all day, so just getting back in it.
Getting back in the groove.
Yeah.
How old are you, by the way?
I'm 21.
All right. Are you studying or no?
No, I quit college past year. Like I did last year and then quit, didn't start again this September.
Okay. I think I quit straight away. Because in England it's different. After 16 you go to college and then university at 21. So after 18...
Well, at 16 you have like a final exam.
Yeah, yeah. And
then you have college for 2 years.
Yes.
And then uni?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Sorry to interrupt.
Sorry?
So you're from the UK as well?
Yeah.
Nice.
Are you from the UK?
No, I'm actually from Canada. I'm from Winnipeg, Manitoba.
Okay.
Nobody knows where that is in Canada, though, so.
Yeah, I do. I know exactly where that's at.
Oh, you know where that is?
Oh, yeah. I've been up there when you've had the blizzards and negative 40 degree temperatures. It sucks.
Oh, it sucks, man. That's why I'm... My goal is to get out of here eventually. So.
We'll help you. Trust me.
Yeah, it's pretty darn cold up here, man. Like winter, peak winter weather, probably minus 45, minus 40.
Crazy.
Cars turning to popsicles. It's crazy, man.
It's crazy. It's crazy. I've never seen so many... You know, extension cords hanging out in front of cars because you have to warm up the engine blocks before you can crank them up.
Well, the UK was bad. It's gonna say minus 40.
Ooh.
So how old are you now, Sammy?
Yeah, I'm 23 next month.
All right.
Yeah. What's it like in France then, like the education system?
Oh, so I had final exam like for high school at 18.
Hey, okay.
And then I had like, I don't know if it's college, uni, you call it whatever. And so I did the first year, like normally I took all courses and all that. And then the second year, which was last year, I went for the first semester and then like started dropping out during COVID.
Was it due to COVID or was it just due to you not enjoying it?
Yeah, both. I mean, I didn't enjoy it, and COVID and us, we didn't have to go to the classes at the uni. So it helped me drop out in a sense.
Yeah, it helped you make your decision, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of people said that. A lot of people said, I've seen it even here. I've seen that they went to online classes. They were like, this isn't the proper experience of uni. So they dropped out.
Yeah, they're right in a sense. I mean, that was bullshit anyway.
You guys got some good conversations going.
Yeah.
I love that.
Talking about education.
Yeah, yo, last night was a lot of guys picked up some nice moves. Where were we? Yeah, I love this. We got to get this going like every day, especially after the stream in the in New York, and then also after or during the Asian session. If people are taking things or you're looking at some, send the chart in to be like, yo, what are you guys thinking of? You guys, is this making sense to you, this chart right here? Or do I need to take a look at something, you know?
It's crazy because remember the last night I went on and it says like 60 unread, and I was like, wow, I've never seen that before. Especially on the, I think it was Asian session chart, to be honest.
Yeah. I mean, obviously, like, I think, like I said, I think we lost a little momentum. Again, I'll always put things on me. I think we lost a little momentum after the wedding. And then when I came back from the wedding and the honeymoon, I needed, like, I feel like I needed that week when I was back to kind of, like, get my train going again. Kind of like Quentin, what you were just going through.
Yeah.
Like you just took a trip to Paris. Now, imagine getting married and going on a honeymoon. How, like, checked out you would feel naturally. Yeah. Not that, like, it's like, oh, I don't want to trade or I don't want to, you know, help the guys in the group or anything like that. It's just you're in this mode of, like, extreme abundance after being surrounded by everyone you love. Not only that, but, like, all the planning that went into it. Then you go on a vacation at a nice resort. It's like, damn, like, this is life. This is amazing. And then coming back to reality, it's tough to stay disciplined and get back on your horse again. But you have to do it. And, you know, sometimes you need a couple of days, sometimes you need a week, and then you'll get back on your horse again. But like I was telling you, Quentin, like that turnaround time, if you can shrink that time down as much as possible, because it's always going to happen. You're always going to get these little, like, either it's a vacation, adversity hits, you go somewhere, something happens. There's always going to be that hiccup of you kind of lose sight of your goals. And you got to realign yourself.
Yeah, definitely.
That happens to me a lot when I go on holidays and it takes me a long time to get back in the groove.
Well, you better get good at it because you got holidays every weekend.
Yeah.
You guys got so many holidays.
Oh.
How many would you say you have a year?
Holidays,
mm-hmm.
Like proper holiday vacation, like out of the country holidays.
No, that's vacation. I'm talking about like holidays, like Christmas. You guys got Ramadan. You guys got, you know, all these. Like the Jewish religion has a ton of holidays. Not to mention they got the Sabbath every. What is that? Every Friday, Quentin.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they basically have Thanksgiving every Friday night.
I'm sorry. I don't want to know, to be honest.
You what?
I'm not too sure.
You're not too sure how many? That doesn't matter. But it's, yeah, I feel like you guys always have a holiday going on. Or like fasting or.
Yeah, fasting's for one full month. And then that's next year now. So.
Jeez.
Two holidays, 2 days. One straight after Ramadan. So the next day. So we celebrate. Like the month that we've had. Then the next one's, you know, when they go to Saudi for Mecca, the pilgrimage.
Okay.
Once they completed that, and the people that decide to go for it that year,
mm-hmm.
Once that's completed, it's like 2-3 weeks, maybe a month, three weeks to a month. And once that's done, the next day we celebrate that as well. It's like Christmas, basically.
Wow.
And then... what else? I don't... That's what I know, to be honest.
Okay.
We should set you up. The Saudi Arabia... Mecca.
Mecca?
Yeah.
I'm not too sure.
You never heard of it?
What was it?
You never heard of it?
You never heard of Mecca?
Yes.
I haven't. I mean, I've heard of Madison Square Garden. That's the Mecca.
the mecca of boxing.
Yeah, that's the, we call that the mecca of like arenas. The that's yeah. the that's the spot. Jamie, I'm taking a look at the setup you were setting.
Yeah, so that's where the brain started to, you know, overanalyze again. Like I could see the current 30-minute breaking the low. Mm-hmm. Of course, it hasn't closed yet, but I know that we also have news coming up in 22 minutes. So it's one of those things where it's like, okay, is this safe to take? Just wait until after the stupid news, you know, how much is it going to affect it?
Yeah, I would wait for after the news. I mean, again, like NZDUSD, I don't trade it. So I don't know how it runs, like the setup when it comes to CPI and how it normally reacts to CPI. That's more of your department. But with this, like what you're getting is a nice clean close on the 30-minute below that support, right? So right now, this candle, looking at the anatomy of the candle, past the low of the previous candle right here, and now it's starting to flip bullish, right? So now you're starting to get that retracement. Can we get a nice retest and resistance formed in this area? And then after news, we take this thing down.
Got it.
Kind of like you had a very clean move before this consolidation right here, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So once you get this consolidation going a little bit, then the next time you're going to get a very – normally you get a very similar setup as you did right here. You're going to get that same length of a push right here if you have a clean move to the left.
Yeah.
Make sense?
Absolutely. And thank you, Gary. I just read it.
Yeah, I wait to the after the news for USD pair now, but I would be looking for sales mainly.
No problem.
Yeah, no, 100%. Dude, you know what I listened to last night was trading. No, yeah, the Trading Nut podcast. Has anybody listened to that?
No.
Nobody knows what the Trading Nut podcast is.
I've seen him on Instagram. I just haven't actually listened to any of them.
Yeah, yes. Kate Hawkins. Let's see. All right, Reese. I'll see you later, buddy. Have a great day, man.
Who did you say he was?
What's up?
Who did you just say he was?
Cam Hawkins, I think his last name is. I know it's Cam.
I thought you said Stephen Hawkins.
No. Yes, it's Stephen Hawkins. And that's Stephen Hawking. This is him. So he's got this podcast.
He's had quite a few big traders on there, hasn't he?
Which Ted's been on there. This is it right here. So this is the one I listened to yesterday, right? 5,000 to 15 million private forex trader reveals a strategy. So he goes by the name of Trader X. The guy doesn't like give himself a name or doesn't tell anyone what his name is. He worked on Wall Street and was able to learn like the way they trade and everything. He goes strictly based on fundamentals. He barely looks at the chart. He says he spends 15 minutes a week charting up the chart here, right? And he basically goes by the fundamentals of knowing like for the next, and he holds trades for months at a time. And he knows like, all right, for the next, you know, couple of months, the dollar is going to be stronger than the New Zealand dollar, or the US dollar is going to be stronger than New Zealand dollar. Right, or the other way around, or Australian dollar, or Brexit. Like, I'm going to short Brexit. I'm going to short the pound in 2016 with Brexit for months at a time, which is what was going on. Right? You guys know the way it looks with Brexit. Right here. Oh,
that's like, New Zealand dollar.
Yeah, I was like, that does not look like GJ. Here we go. So he basically caught this whole move right here, anticipating. This is the monthly chart. So he could have basically held his trade here for about 127 days. 100, yeah, no, 427 days here. All right, so that's around 13, 14 months. 15 months. Yeah. So yeah, that podcast is good for, you know, especially if you're not a strategy hopper and you're able to listen to other people's advice or, you know, the way that they trade, stuff like that. And you can stick to your own strategy and pull little things out from other people. That is a great podcast. Now, if you can't do that and you want to try everything and what everyone's doing, then that podcast is a little dangerous for you. But I just love hearing how other people look at the markets, how they think, how they trade, everything. Like, in order to be the best of the best, you got to be humble and you got to be able to pick little things from other people and use it on your own, but test it first. But you got to just be a sponge of information.
All right, I got to roll for work myself. Got a 9 o'clock meeting, so but I'll post in the chat if I catch this NU trade.
Good shit, man. Yeah, keep me updated on that one. Let's see what you do. Generally. Or if you have time, just send the before chart of, like, you know, you're getting ready to take a trade. Just send it in real quick. Okay. All right, man.
All right, I'll see you at 2.
Yes, sir. Looking forward to it.
All right, brother.
See you, buddy.
See you, fellas.
Right. I'm curious what, like, some of your goals are with trading. Like, I know, like, personally, like, what a lot of you guys are doing, but, like, are you guys more on terms of, just got to stop the break even with GJ? Cool. Are you guys more at, how do I ask this? More in the mind frame of, like, I want to be one of the best in the world, or I just want to be as good as I could possibly be? Quentin, we could start with you.
I guess I would say one of the best, but how many would I put in the best is the question. Like, I don't want to be the best in the world, like the top one, because I think it's hard to define.
Yeah.
With what, but yeah, it motivates me, and it means more to me to say I want to be one of the best in the world than the best I can possibly be.
You mean that means more to you?
Yeah, that means more to me.
Awesome. So now what about that is important to you? Just being recognized like that?
No, I don't care about being recognized. I don't care about what people think of me. I just want to know that. I just want to know that about myself, that I am above the majority.
Yeah. That's good, man. And, you know, especially in the hardest market in the world, it's like, if you're able to do that and at least be one of the top, right? That, you know, you're doing your job, because, like, whenever you guys do anything, you want to be the best at, you know, you want to be the best you could possibly be at it. In everything, you just want to be great at everything that you do, whether it's being a father, whether it's being a husband, whether it's being do we have any ladies? No, not today. Whether it's being a trader, a businessman, a football player, want to be the best you could possibly be at that. And you want to be, you know, obviously, like, being recognized by other people and other people's opinions doesn't really matter. But at the same time, like, you want, like, that is a great feeling, being one of the best in the world at something. Like, that's a purpose right there. And if you could do it, which it's always possible, if one person could do it, you could do it, you know? But, like, why not you? And that's that question you got to ask yourself. How about you, Sammy?
Sorry, what was the question? As well, the room.
What's like your main goal with trading between these two things? Is it one of the best in the world, or just as good as you could possibly get?
That's a tough question.
What's like the driving force for you?
Everything I do, like, this is something when I was about 14, 15, I wanted always to be the best, no matter what I did, whether it was play football, play tennis. I just wanted to be better than my friends, better than, just better, just to stand out, let's say, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But obviously you can't get there without just sitting around and pussyfooting around. You got to put in the work.
Yeah.
I knew that from a young age. So I always believe you put in the work, you will get your rewards. But now I want to be the best. I want to be the best in the world, because I know if I can get the best out of myself, I can be the best in the world.
Mm-hmm. It's like, you just got to ask yourself, like, what is it going to take to be the best in the world? And that's just being the best version of yourself. And that's what I'm always pushing you guys to do.
Yeah, there's so many potential you can unlock, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you have it. And you guys are so young. You, Quentin. I don't know how young Praveen is. Praveen, how old are you, if you're listening? You can just type it in the chat. That's one thing I love, too, that Praveen is in here. And there's such a language barrier between the two of us. But, like, it still works. Like, he can understand what I'm saying. He sees us taking trades and stuff. And, you know, you guys all know that one of my favorite parts about the group is just communicating with you guys all over the world. It's awesome.
Yeah, what was I saying? I think we all have so much potential we can unlock. And that potential will always be there.
Mm-hmm.
Don't ever think that there's no more potential left.
Yeah.
Because then you're just static for the rest of your life then.
Mm-hmm.
So that even like, to the point I've got now, if I just thought, oh, I can't get any better than this, I'd just stay the same. I wouldn't improve. I wouldn't get the best out of myself.
Yeah.
When I'm always questioning myself, that's when I know I'm getting the best out of myself every day.
Yeah.
So even when I'm 30, 40, 50, I'm going to keep this level of questioning, level of discipline, this level of asking more of myself every single day.
Demanding.
I don't want that fire to ever die out.
No. No, you're right. And like, honestly, you know, we have our mission statement. We have our mission as a group is to be the best group in the world. So like, to be the best group in the world, you need to have some of the best traders in the world in that group. You know, and like people wanting to be some of the best in the world and recognized as such.
Yeah.
So like, you know, there's a bunch of us that are well on our way to becoming like great traders. Like a lot of you guys that are putting a lot of work in. Quentin's putting a lot of work in. Sammy's putting a ton of work in. You're already trading full time. Gary's killing it with his analysis. Praveen, we still got more to learn and stuff like that. But Carlos, 3-1 now. We got a lot of room for improvement that we could like really push you to another limit where you could be trading full time. And I want to set that goal for you for the end of the year. But like, there's a bunch of guys in this group that are killing it. That I could definitely see. You know, I mean, all of you. But I mean, there's some people that don't put as much effort in that obviously you could tell, like maybe they're not equipped for something like that. But most of you, for the most part, again, I've done a pretty good job like vetting people in and out. So I want to make sure I get the right people in here.
Where's Kat disappeared to? Because when I first joined, she was quite a regular.
Yeah, Kat's definitely still in here. We talk on almost a daily basis. She sends me her AARs and stuff, but she's going through a difficult time right now. I guess I'll just leave it at that. I don't want to, you know, blow up her spot or anything like that, which I don't think she would care, but just to keep the privacy there. If you want to know, like, just reach out to her and be like, I hope you're doing well. Haven't seen you in a little bit. But she just hit like a little hiccup, not with her trading, but personal life and stuff like that. So she's trying to get back on her horse. I've been helping her with that.
Yeah,
she's another one that's been really participating in everything and kind of fell off for a second. But again, we all have those ebbs and flows through our lives, through our trading. You know, you'll have really good weeks where you're showing up every single day, you're participating, you're sending your analysis and everything, and all of a sudden your discipline slips, you take a loss, you take a really bad loss, you start over trading or something like that, and then all of a sudden the confidence of appearing every single day and participating, sending charts, that starts to die down a little bit, right? And I can always tell. Don't think I can't tell. I always tell when you guys are going through something, and that's when you'll see me reach out and be like, yo, what's going on? And like, maybe go over something, you want to hop on a Zoom, go through something. But like, when you're going through that, please reach out to me first. Like, be the one that it's just like, yo, Steph, just hit a bad loss. My psychology got hit. Instead of like having your pride and like not wanting to reach out and just keeping to yourself and trying to get through it on your own, like, you're going to get through it a lot quicker if we just go through it and we just, you know, get to the bottom of what's happening, go through some trades, and then you know, kind of pick up that fire after that. Hey, Gary, you there?
Sorry, you're talking to me?
Yes, sir.
What was that again?
Yeah, what's your overall goal between these two things? Is it being the one of the best in the world, or is it being
100% best in the world?
Yeah, I thought so.
100%.
I guess that on my own.
Yeah,
it's good shit, man.
Because you can always, if you say you want to be the best you can be, you can always be better. You can always be better.
Yeah.
You know, you got to push for it. You got to work for it more. Yeah. Being one of the best in the world, you know, everyone's going to compare themselves to you.
Love how quick that answer was, too. Like, there was no question. That's how it's got to be. That's how it's got to be with you guys with success, too. Knowing that, like, if you guys aren't profitable yet or you guys aren't trading full-time yet, you got to know, no matter what, that you guys are going to be trading full-time. You guys are going to be as best as you possibly can be. You guys are going to be one of the best in the world at some point. And you already look at yourself like that. You just need to put in the work to get there. You already know. Like Sammy or Gary or Quentin or Praveen, Carlos, you guys already know you are that person. You're the greatest trader in the world. But, you know, now it just takes some time for you to get to that area. You're just not there yet. It's almost like, who's like a character? I'm trying to think of like a movie where they did, it's like a prequel of that person's life, and they're not where, like, they're not the best in the world yet. What movie can I use? Maybe just any, like, biographical movie of just showing the beginning of someone's life. You know, like, this is your story. And the beginning of your life is just like you were born, you got your family and stuff like that, and they're showing in this movie the ebbs and flows of your life, the things that you go through to get to the person you're going to be. But now you're just in the beginning of that phase.
Have you seen there's a movie about the football player Ronaldo, okay, where he was like 9 or 10, and he was sweeping the street, like he was just sweeping the street. And he's getting paid, but that's what he was. He was a cleaner as a kid because his dad didn't have a job, his mom couldn't work.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like just cleaning the street to make a living for his family. And now he's the best in the world at what he does. So if you want to check that movie out, there's a trailer on YouTube. If you want to watch it now, it does show clips of what he used to do and how how he was as a child and how he was brought up. And then even now, he did an interview where he said to the interviewer that I took my son to where I grew up, and my son says to me, "No, Dad, you're lying. You didn't grow up here." You know, so it's kind of crazy.
Yeah, no, what's it called?
It's just called Ronaldo.
Okay, I'll check that out. Yeah, I like him a lot. There was a thing that he was, it was like a video on Instagram of him talking about how, like, you know, his father passed away, and you know, his father's never been able to see a lot of the success, and that's the one thing that kills him.
Yeah,
like no matter what he does, his father's never going to be able to like witness it, and he'll be able to see his reaction. But Gary, thanks for saying that. Don't trade it, just wait, Praveen. Yeah, Praveen, we'll see what we end up getting. Wait for the reaction to the news. Now, this is PPI. So this is really like what producers are showing what the prices are. Like change in the price of finished goods and services sold by producers, right? So sold by the managers of, or this is the owners of the companies. So like, what are the prices that they're incurring? What are the prices that they're paying for things, right? As opposed to the consumer, which is us, what are we paying? What are our prices at? So we got about a minute left. Let's see how
it... Sorry.
Nice, Quinn.
I think they should make more movies about biographies. And
what's up?
I think they should make more movies on like people
biopics.
Yeah.
I there's one coming out that I'm real pumped for. New Elvis movie coming out.
Okay.
That's gonna be awesome. I grew up listening to him, so because of my grandfather.
Elvis.
But it's gonna be like, have you guys seen the Queen movie?
No.
Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Yeah, great film. Yeah, so that was like a big biopic about Freddie Mercury and Queen. This is gonna be the same thing, but Elvis.
Did one about Elton John as well, didn't they?
Yeah, Rocket Man. I didn't see that. So we ended up getting unemployment claims coming out much higher than previous, and much higher than, or not much, but higher than previous and higher than forecast over here. PPI came out same as expected. Core PPI came out a little bit less than what was expected, and less than previous as well, which is good. I know it says it's in red here, but that means prices are decreasing, which is good. Normally, like inflation, it's good because people are buying things, prices are rising, things are doing good. That's why the number being less than previous is not good. But in today's terms, when inflation is the way it is right now, this is a good number. Or this is like good that prices are starting to decrease a little bit. And again, like CPI came out much lower than previous over here, right? Month to month, much lower than April's. Yeah, looking over here at gold now, gold is starting to retrace back up over here. GJ is now ranging. Right? GJ is sitting in this range now, and now we need to wait for price to break out. Unless we're holding a higher low here with a bullish close. Problem is we rejected that area. But is this candle creating a bottom wick? I'm going to flip bullish over here. No. Yeah, we're sitting in a range here. Now, safe buys are going to be above 157,400. And safe sells are now going to be below 156,400. gold. Let's see if we end up holding a resistance right over here. We analyze this real quick. So the daily, again, we're holding that resistance up here, right? This candle did grab liquidity past the high of the previous candle, but flip bearish. And right now, I could very well see us continuing right back down to 1830. Now, but keep in mind, this is going to be a key area. This is going to be a major key area that you guys got to pay attention to. 1830 is a very psychological number and a very strong level as well. So can we end up continuing right back down to that area? Nice resistance over here. Lower lows, lower highs on the 4 hour. 4 hour is going to close in 30 minutes. So maybe the next one creates that top wick. We stay right where we're at, and then we continue down to retest the lows. But we've just been retesting lows, you know, all previous couple of weeks over here. Looking at the 1 hour, retesting this level. Let's see if we hold that as a resistance to continue down. And then you got the 30 minute over here. Let's see if we stay below this area and continue down. Give me 1 second, guys.
Curry, when did you start trading? What age? If you're still here.
Talking to me?
Yeah.
Sorry. About 4 years ago, properly. But I started off on them fucking signal services.
Okay.
Thought, saw them, easy money, wasn't, lost a lot. But then about 2 years ago, properly.
Yeah, mine was similar, how I started as well. Signal service, bullshit.
Yeah, about 2 years ago, I thought, nah, I said this, I'm gonna do it myself.
That's the best way, man.
100%.
How are you finding it? Have you taken any challenges, or are you doing your own yet?
I've been trading a small account, not like a, you know, nothing major, but take out little withdrawals every now and then just to pay a bill or whatever, just to, you know, get used to it. But I did a funding talent challenge.
Okay.
And I passed phase one literally like the day before they cancelled them.
All right.
So I got like my account details for phase two, woke up in the morning, and then they put that alert up saying they've taken them off, so.
Did you get a refund or no?
Yeah, I got a refund, yeah.
That's
all right. And then I just left it, but I'm going to be doing my Forex funds, I'm going to try them.
Yeah, they're good, I'm with them.
Yeah, I'm going to try them like, end of the month, I think. I'm just taking it easy on my own at the minute. Just been practicing patience, really.
Yeah.
Quite impressed with the group, though. I was reading the Asian session last night, and you know, it's Thursday, and everyone's only taking like 3, 4, 5 trades for the week.
Yeah.
I know people that have like taken 3 times that at least.
Bloody hell.
He's just over trading.
I think once you overcome that level of discipline, you're good to go.
Yeah, that's it, man. I mean, it's like you said you've taken 1 trade this week.
Yeah.
You know? Patience pays.
Definitely.
You've got 2 funded accounts, right, Sammy?
Sorry?
Did you pass twice the challenges?
Yeah. Yes, yeah.
You got the 2 accounts.
Yeah.
And so you were saying you have the account set on a trade copier.
Yeah.
You have your personal account as your main?
Yeah, my personal account main, and then them two, whatever I take on my main gets copied on those two accounts.
Yeah. So you never look at the funded accounts?
No, not really.
Is that something you find easier? Like, so you just see what happens on your main account? It just does its thing?
Yeah, it's a lot easier to manage when it's your own money. And when you're looking at, I don't know, I think that maybe this is a problem with me, that you tend to take care of your own hard-earned money than a funded account which isn't yours.
Yeah, I feel.
You know what I mean? Like, if you've worked hard for 100 grand, let's say, and you're trading on that account, you're going to think, shit, I need to manage my trades properly. Whereas the other two, I don't know, I think that's a problem with me. Well, I find it easier managing on my real account than two accounts that have just been funded.
What was the question, Sammy?
No, Quinton was asking about the two accounts I have.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously my main account, personal account, is the head. And what I take on the main account gets copied on the funded accounts.
Okay.
And I said I find that easier to manage on my main account because, I don't know, I see it as my own hard-earned cash.
Sure.
So I manage it more and I take care of it a lot more precisely. Whereas if I just had 200, the funded 200K account, I'll take care of it, but not as much as my own personal one.
Sure.
I don't know if that's a problem with me or if that's with a lot of people.
I think what you're doing is right. Like, whatever makes sense to you, it's very subjective. And like, if you pay more attention and it's easier for you to trade your personal account than it is a funded account, then trade on your real account and use that as the backup account, the ones that get copied.
Yeah.
You know, so like, but like, if it's the other way around, do that. You know, like, whatever makes sense to you.
Quinton, are you planning on doing a challenge or?
I'm planning on doing it, but I'm not ready at all.
Okay.
Quinn, normally I do this on like a private Zoom, but like what we can do is set up like a, if that's really a goal of yours, I've done this with a couple other people and it's worked. Like Donnie has a full account now. Who else did I do this with? Luke, I'm doing this with. So what we're doing is for the next 2 weeks, right? So what date is it right now? We can start next week, right? So the week of the 15th, which is a Sunday, all the way to the 20th, which is a Friday, what you can do is push to make anywhere from 7.5% to 10% in that week. Do you think that's possible for you?
I don't really think so. I mean, I haven't been really trading at all.
Okay.
These past weeks.
Okay. Yeah, have you been even on a demo account or just watching?
Yeah, I've been backtesting. I've been like journaling trades live backtested.
Okay.
Taking small trades, but in the past month, maybe I have taken like 4 trades.
Okay.
With less than a person's risk.
Okay. So it's super important for you to have like goals for the week, goals for the month. Like what am I pushing for this month?
Yeah, definitely. And I wanted to go over that with you. And I sent you a message this morning. I guess you
didn't see. Oh, did he? Like I said, I was on the. I'm gonna pause that. It's too intense of music. What's it called? This morning I was on like an hour long Zoom with Luke before the stream.
So yeah, no problem. Yeah, I heard it. I knew you would get to it after the session. But well, I sent you.
I'll get to it after the session.
I knew you would see my message like after this session. Yeah. I didn't worry about it, but I was telling you that I wanted to do a Zoom with you to go over like the trading part and planning on my habits and what I can implement to really progress.
And have improve. We done a trading plan yet?
Yeah, we did that.
That's what I thought. Okay.
I wanted to plan the milestones where I have to on what I have to do this week for the next month.
Yeah.
And 4 months and all that, like really plan on.
Yeah, no, that's the exciting part, is having that that blueprint. It's like, okay, this is what I'm looking at for the week. This is what I'm looking to do for the week. And what you can do now that you have the backtester is like try to backtest, like, you know how like you could download new data on the backtester?
Yeah.
I was going over this before of what I do, but what you can do is go back the previous week, like once this week is over, or do the last week, and go over last week's pair, whatever pair you trade. I think it's GJ, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So go over GJ. Actually, I wouldn't do last week because it was just ranging the whole time. But go back a couple of weeks and try to gain, go through Sunday to Friday and try to gain at least 5%. And don't rewind, don't fast forward, don't do anything. Just try to gain 5% that week and see how you do. And whatever that is, it's like the benchmark. Whatever you get to at Friday, maybe it's only 3%. It's like, okay, I was only able to get 3% this week. How do I gain 5%? How could I have gained 7.5% to 10%? What trades could I have taken that I missed? How could I have taken a better trade instead of the one that I lost? You know, like just keep doing that, journal those. And what you want to do is aim for 7.5% to 10% per week. And what you can, once you get that, maybe you either do a demo account or a live account in the real market in the next few weeks, trying to do that after doing it on the backtester. Then once you can get that 7.5% to 10% 2 weeks in a row, then I suggest anybody go do a challenge. Because the good thing about a challenge is if you can gain 7.5% to 10% per week, 2 weeks in a row, you should at least be able to end the first phase of a challenge in profit, which then gives you a free retry to try it again. And it gives you unlimited retries if you end in profits. So now, like, you could just, like, the first time you do a challenge, maybe you're not successful the first time. You're not used to trading with that amount of money. You end in profits, but you just don't hit that 10% goal, right? Then you can retry it. And it's like, okay, now I, like, know more about doing a challenge. Like, I've already felt this for the last month, right? I was able to end in profits. So how do I improve on last month, this month?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So all these little milestones you're going to be able to hit. But right now, the main focus should be like next week, actually this weekend, and you know, up until this weekend, because it's still Thursday, go start a session anywhere, you know, throughout this week or throughout this month or the month before that, wherever you want to start this backtesting account, try to gain 5% in a week.
Okay. Yeah. And, yeah, I was watching the live from Monday, Tuesday, I don't remember. And you didn't know, you weren't sure if you could download the data for the current or right the previous week on SoftFX.
You can.
You can.
I checked.
All right.
Yeah, that's actually what I was doing. Like, I don't normally do this, but I was able to go back and see, like, how late into like today's present time have we been able to download the data. So like, yeah, you could do the week before now. Like, you could back test the week of May, I would say April 1st to April 6th. I believe you'll be able to do.
Okay. You mean May or April?
April 1st is like Sunday. That's Sunday. And then that Monday becomes May 1st. That makes sense?
No.
So looking at the calendar, go look at the calendar.
How far can we go in downloading data?
We could go up until a week before. So you could go up to a week before on downloading the data for yourself.
So right now we should be able to have like April 25th to May 1st.
Yeah, you do. You could do that one. That'll be there. Just make sure you go to the data center and update the data.
Okay, yeah.
So DJ is interesting over here. We're starting to flip bearish on the hourly. Only thing is that 4 hours is going to close soon. 4 hours is going to close in 12 minutes. And the 4 hour over here, previous 4 hour candle ended up closing with no bottom wick. This candle ends up closing a very bullish, weak bullish candle with a very tall top wick. Gold over here is starting to hold that resistance here, but you want to wait for that candle to close. We'll see if it closes like that so we can continue back down, top wick on the next candle. Candle flips bearish and continues right back down into this key area over here. That's what I'm looking for the rest of the day. But at the same time, I'm pretty much done. Right? I may see a perfect setup that I like, but right now I've already taken my trades. So with that being said, guys, I'm going to hop off. I think that was a great session, great discussion, great breakdowns. Everything was pretty much on key. I know, Sammy, you were able to grab that GJ trade. Anybody else grab anything else?
I took the trade, but it ended up with like zero.
Okay.
Because I closed a part in loss and a part in profit, like equal parts.
So, you know, record that in a journal and then also your trading AAR and just write to yourself like what you could have done differently and all that stuff. Just be very critical of yourself.
Okay. I took GJ pre-London.
Beautiful. Yes, that's right. You posted it in a London chat. Good shit, man. But yeah, right back at it tomorrow morning, Eastern Standard Time, 6:30. I will see you guys then.
Cool.
Good day.
You guys have an amazing day, all right?
Yeah.
Great job showing up. Bye. See you tomorrow.